nervous.
No, joking.
Very nervous meeting you.
I don't want you to be nervous. We brought you out first before we meet your lovely daughter. Do not shake. We're fine.
I'm shaking.
No, do not shake.
Where's her little girl?
Tell me all about Lucy.
Wow, where would you like me to start?
From birth, if you want.
From birth. Well, when she was born, we didn't know whether she... We were told that there was something wrong.
Lucy was diagnosed with cancerous tumours of the eyes. We were in a cancer bubble for a long time, which was horrendous, I'm not going to lie. It was really bad. And we were in and out of hospital, and I had to watch them pin my daughter down because she didn't want this. And she cried, and she kicked, and she screamed. I've never seen Lucy cry as much as she did. You look at these nurses and doctors, and they're saying to you, you know, we know what we're doing, and you have to trust them. You have to trust them. And that's the hard part, because you're the mum. She sang to the fish in the ocean. As she stands now, she hasn't got any vision at all. On top of that, Lucy has a chromosome 16 duplication. I have it. It can affect mental health, it can affect autism traits. She's globally developmentally delayed as well. So she struggles with communication. She can't hold a conversation, not really. And the seashells clapped. Good girl. And the seagulls flapped.
Didn't hear them, amazing.
However, long time ago, when she was very little, she had a little tiny keyboard. And we took it into hospital with us. And she played Twinkle Twinkle Little Star perfectly on it. And the nurse came over. And she thought that it was pre-recorded. And I said, no, Lucy's playing it. And the nurse just went, that's spectacular. And that's when Daniel came in and started working with her.
I'm Daniel Bath, and I do a lot of teaching through Amber Trust, which is a charity that helps blind musicians. Our lessons aren't like normal piano lessons. Because she can't see what's happening, I started using a method of where I would play the piano, and she would put her hands on top of my hands so she could feel which fingers were doing what. I've never met anybody in my career who has the same depth of understanding of music.
Hi Lucy. Hi Lucy, it's Claudia. Hi darling, lovely to meet you. Thank you for coming.
The music is the way that she communicates, and that's how she makes her place in the world.
Now, it's a big step coming up to the piano. Ready? Big step. Good girl. Well done. Come and sit down in the middle.
Down.
I just went, find the pedal.
We should say that often at the end of a performance,
yes,
Lucy covers her ears.
She likes the applause, but she doesn't like the sound of the applause.
Yes.
So her fingers go in her ears for sensory reasons.
Yes, I don't have to tell people not to.
She loves applause.
Okay, fine.
100%.
Now, ready? In a minute you're going to play Nocturne in B-flat minor by Chopin. Should we start playing? See? Here we go.
She can play this piece. How does she study? I mean, how, this is incredible.
Mm-hmm.
play so beautifully. I mean, this is... I never seen anything like this. This is impossible.
Lucy, it was so lovely to meet you. You were tremendous.
Oh, she's yay! You're a clap.
Only one, though.
Yeah.
More, better than none.
More than I deserve.
I'm speechless. I don't know what to say. I really don't know what to say. It's...
For two pernickety, opinionated pains in the asses to be completely flummoxed and speechless.
Yeah.
I mean, you know, technically speaking, she sang those melodies.
Yeah.
You sing, when you play, it's
I
like...
put a voice here. And I always tell the people I work with, I say, don't play just da, da, because when you sing it, you have to think about, right? Yeah.
Basically turning a percussion instrument,
yeah,
a tuned percussion instrument into
a breathing voice.
A breathing, living,
yeah,
vocal instrument. And it took a 13-year-old girl to show us how to do that.
Yes, she can. She can. She really sings so well.
And she did it
there.
I feel very, very lucky. If you told me that I was going to live one of my strongest musical experiences of the past 5-10 years sitting in a train station in Leeds, I would have been, like, completely out of your mind.
We've asked everyone who played the street piano at Leeds City Station to gather together so that they can meet each other and discover who they've really been playing for.
What grade are you at now?
I'm five now.
Oh, are you grade five? Yeah.
So Leeds has basically given us everything.
Yeah.
We've had ABBA.
We have a version of.
Thank you.
We have jazz.
We've had jazz.
Few jazz. Some classical repertoire.
We had a lot of life.
Yeah. So let's discuss who is in the running to go to the Royal Festival.
Okay.
There is Liam.
Yes.
He's a romantic. Emotionally, he gives you a warm feeling.
Yeah.
And
yeah,
he opens the door for loads of people to give Chopin a go. And that can only be a good thing. There's also Daniel,
yes,
with the Goo Goo Dolls.
Yes. And I don't want the world to see me, 'cause I... Is it Lucy who made you both cry?
Lucy's challenge in life is beyond all our imagination.
The perfect example of the transformative power of music. And I like the kind of unjaded nature,
yeah,
of Josh. A bossa nova is not the easiest thing to play, but it had emotion in it. It was beautiful.
It was perfect also. He doesn't want to do too much.
Yeah.
Right? He's just
in
the flow.
Yeah. Exactly.
Just 14.
Yeah. How do you compare the incomparable?
Well, that's not my job. That's...
I know. It's a question of help.
But it's really hard.
What are we trying to achieve at the Royal Festival? What do we want the audience to feel? That's really what we have to ask ourselves. I really would love the audience to leave with their kind of their mouths just like wide open in wonder.
Hello.
Hi. It's so lovely to see you all together. We just want to say thank you so much for coming. and for playing so beautifully for us. I'm going to say something now, which is, we haven't told you everything.
Oh, really? Mm-hmm.
You played for those in Leeds Station. You also played for two others. You played for the world's greatest pianist and one of the world's greatest performers. So please welcome Lang Lang and Mika.
Don't. No.
Well, firstly, hello. It's nice to see you in person. We've been watching you in the most glamorous of all locations.
We are next to that toilet.
Exactly. So we were just behind the black curtain. You didn't know that you were being watched. And maybe you would have done things differently, but thank goodness that you didn't, because you were yourselves. And that is so rare.
You really played so beautifully, and each of you are so different, you know. We are seeing like a musical journey through different style of music.
As a thank you, we're organizing this very special concert that we are putting together at the Royal Festival Hall.
Yeah.
And just as a thank you, we'd like to invite all of you as our VIP guests to attend this concert.
Yeah. Wow.
Lovely. Which is going to happen later on in the year. But the truth is...
Yeah.
We have another. Not more.
Actually, we want to invite one of you to perform at the Royal Festival Hall.
So, after a real serious discussion for a few hours,
that person
is Lucy.
Honestly, didn't think that Lucy's name would be called out.
Despite the really high standard, there was a moment where Lang Lang and I remembered the power of music and the reason why we make music and what music can do, and it just completely blew us away. And that was thanks to Lucy. So
thank you. We
would love her to come.
Absolutely. Yeah, thank you.
I see many great pianists performing, but this time it's quite different. You can be a great pianist, but if you're always on stage, you're always practicing, sometimes the emotion become a little bit less genuine, but she plays so beautifully. And that emotion is so sincere, it's so direct. And to play at the Royal Festival Hall, I think she will do great.
She speaks through music. She's speaking through her piano playing. That's what makes it different, because you feel like it's important to her to communicate. And what she has to say is just so urgent in her own way that it deserves to be heard on the most prestigious stage.
Right, it has.